us begin. In a nice quiet seat of meditation, and let the legs be crossed and the eyes be closed, and let's take 75 minutes out of our day now to tune into the present moment. And it is so fun to be in the dreams and in the memories, because there's so much fun to be had, and there's so much to think about, and there's so much to remember. But there is a value in being right here in the moment, right now. So let's come in on the breath. Big inhale, fill up the lungs. And open mouth, exhale. Squeezing out from the pelvic floor, pulling the navel back and deep, elongate the low spine. Let the shoulders tuck back down in the sockets. Another breath, beautiful. Feel the fresh energy coming into the body. And feel the heavy used up elements leaving the body. One more cycle through. And very good. On an inhale, sweep the arms up and high overhead. Reach up and take the hands into pranam. Bringing the hands to the prayer hands and pointing the fingers high to the sky. Big inhale as you press up. And as you exhale, bring the pranam behind the skull. Try not to let the hands point fingers backward, and let the elbows nice and wide. Eventually the wrist will move all the way down to the middle spine. Sit nice and tall. One more breath here. Spread the elbows wide. As you inhale, come back in high. And exhale, take the hands to pranam at the heart. Inhale, the hands out in front, pointing. And exhale, pranam at the heart. Inhale, pranam overhead. And exhale, pranam behind the head. We're going to do this cycle 3 times. Inhale, up. Exhale to the chest. Inhale, forward. And exhale, back to the heart. Inhale, up. Exhale, behind. Inhale, up. Exhale, heart. Inhale, forward. Exhale, heart. One more time through. Inhale, up. Inhale behind the skull. Inhale up. And exhale heart. Inhale forward. And exhale heart. Very good. Inhale, sweep the arms up and high overhead. And then take the hands behind the back, fingertips pointing away from you. Lift the pelvic dish and push forward. Open the heart. Open the throat, powerful. Maybe expand the flesh under the chin. Stay for the exhale. And on your breath, let the hip come back to the earth, sweeping the arms up and high overhead. Inhale. And exhale, take the thumbs to the third eye and set an intention. A powerful intention from your fearless heart, and allow yourself to feel genuinely this intention as reality. Big inhale now. And bow forward, so humble. Honor the practice. Thank yourself for showing up on the mat today. Invite the ujjayi pranayama, the breath in through the nose and out through the nose. Allow there to be a powerful activation from the root of the spine. Big inhale. Big exhale, squeezing out. Let it all go. One more cycle through the ujjayi breath. And squeeze out from the pelvic floor. Very nice. On an inhale, let's come up over our crossed ankles and find the neutral tabletop with the shoulders over the wrists and the hips over the knees. Let's just find a nice cat-cow to begin. Inhale, arching the spine to let the heart shine. And exhale, tucking the tail. Continue with the cat-cow. Lubricate the body.
Link the breath with the movement.
And if you'd like to add any movements side to side, perhaps, or front and back, allow yourself to become comfortable here. Squeezing out from the pelvic floor. Strong arms, 10 fingers gripping. One more cycle through. And as you exhale, rounding, push yourself all the way back to the child pose. Let the hip come to the heel. Take a breath. If you'd like to come up onto the fingertips and roll the shoulders out. And as you exhale, let the heart sink down and through. Big inhale at the bottom. And stay for the breath. When you're ready, slide through low onto the belly. And let the Sphinx pose settle in. Take the elbows under the chest and pull the heart up and through. Press the tops of the feet down into the earth. And as you exhale, unhinge the elbows as much as feels good and push the heart to the sky. Relax the glutes, baby cobra. And stay for the exhale. Deep inner looking, the self-study of yoga. All eight limbs active today. One more breath here. And hold. Very good. Inhale, belly button moves first up through table. And exhale, push it back into a child pose. And then round up to have a seat on the feet. Untuck the toes. Find this nice modified virasana here. And take a breath. Reach the arms up and high overhead. And then exhale, take the hands down to the earth. Gentle, intense top of the foot stretch. Just lift the feet as much as feels good. Lift the knees, I mean. And bow, only stay for as long as feels nice. And then when you're ready, come up onto the knees, tuck the toes, reach the arms up and high overhead. And as you exhale, just find a nice gentle camel pose, pushing the hip forward, open the heart, open the throat. And stay for the exhale. Gather the strength from the core, circle the hands up and high behind the ears. And exhale, fold it to take it down to the tabletop. Shake it out if you need to, wiggle, waggle out the tail. And then when you're ready, take your right hand forward and the left leg straight back. Big inhale. And exhale, plugging knee to elbow. Very good. Inhale, lengthen again. Bend the left knee, sweep back, find the foot, revolve the tiger. Big breath, kicking away. And stay for the exhale. Nice. Inhale, lengthen again. And exhale, take the right hand to the earth, take the left knee to the nose. Set the left foot down between the hands. Rise up on the right toes, inhale. And as you exhale, step the right foot up to meet the left. Take a nice halfway lift, lengthen the low spine. And exhale, fold deep to the earth. Powerful, lift the quadriceps, grounding in. And feel the hip separate from the low back. Feel the head of the femur in the hip socket, digging in through all 10 toes. And then on an inhale, burst all the way up and high, or Vastasana, hands reach up overhead. As you exhale, take the right hand to the right hip and extend the left arm deep over the top ear. Big inhale, and just hold. Feel the side body lengthen, grounding through the knife edge of the left foot. Inhale, both arms back up through center. And exhale, take it to the left. Left hand pressing the hip right. Right arm extending over the top ear. Long through the side body. And stay for the breath. Inhale, both arms reach back and high to the sky. And exhale, fold to the earth. So nice. Take a nice halfway lift at the bottom. And fold, grab the back of the calves, give it three breaths, Uttanasana. Pull yourself down and deep. Heel toe the feet nice and tight together if they're not. And use the arm strength to seat the shoulder blade into the socket. Stay for the exhale. Very nice. Hands down, fingertips, inhale, right leg straight back. Exhale, right knee, right elbow, touch it. Inhale, right leg up over the left shoulder. Gaze up, see the toes. Stay for the exhale. Inhale, right leg sweeps straight back. And exhale, right foot to the earth. Left foot steps back into the plank. Find a big breath in plank. Inhale. Exhale, dip the right knee to the earth. Feel the obliques. Inhale, plank. Exhale, left knee dips. Inhale, plank. Exhale, knees, chin, chest, anahata heart pose. Take the hands under the shoulders, drop the elbows, use the hands for support. Big inhale, walk the knees closer or further, depending on what you need, and try to reach the chin out. Expand the windpipe. Endocrine thyroid stimulation. Now, take the hands underneath yourself. Bring the hands together like a volleyball player and lay the pelvic dish right onto the forearms. Try to press the hands flat into the earth and just float on the hip bone and let the hip bone press right into the radius and the ulna. Really good for the carpal tunnel alignment. Gentle. Expand. And hold. Very good. When you're ready, knees down, let the hands come out from underneath. Take the fingertips out wide and bring the feet together in the butterfly legs. Press the feet together and find baby king cobra. Start by using the arm strength to press the scapula back and tuck the chin to the chest. Find a long neck on the back side, and then as you inhale, open the heart, open the throat and lift. Straighten the arms as much as feels good. And feel the power pressing the feet together as well. Let the pelvic dish connect the earth. Very good. When you're ready, take it back down to the earth. Bring the hands under the shoulders. Inhale up through table. And exhale, push it back, child pose. Inhale, round it all the way back up through cat. Come to the neutral table. Shake it out if you need to. Waggle out the tail. Feels so good in the body as we come alive. Inhale, left hand forward, right leg straight back. Exhale, left knee, right elbow connection. Inhale, lengthen, sweep back, find the foot, revolve the tiger. Kick away, open the shoulder. Stay for the exhale. Inhale, lengthen again. And exhale, left hand to the earth, right knee touch nose. And set the right foot down between the hands, rise up on the left toes. And exhale, step the left foot up to meet the right. Heel, toe, feet nice and tight, big lift. And fold it down deep. Maybe the hands working the earth. Maybe even working behind the feet. Stay for the exhale. And then when you're ready, burst all the way up and high, or Bhastasana, hands reach up overhead. Take the left hand to the left hip, balance on the left foot, extend the right leg out to the side, extend the right arm over the top ear, steady focus your gaze, maybe to the sky, and as you exhale, plug in into elbow connection with control. Beautiful. Inhale, lengthen. And exhale, plug in. One more. Inhale, lengthen. And exhale, plug it in. Very good. Inhale, back to center, reach up and high. Really grounding to the standing leg. And to the opposite side, right hand, right hip. Balancing on the right foot, extend the left leg out, steady focus to drishti. And connect knee to elbow. Really feel the body. You know what it is. You know where it is. Exhale. Plug in one more. Big breath, lengthen. And exhale. All five toes working on the standing leg, grounding you. Inhale, sweep back and high. It's so hard. And as you exhale, cactus and nice back bend. Maybe take the hands to the hip and press forward. And feel the sciatic. On the inhale, circle the elbows up and high behind the ears. And exhale, hinge at the waist and fold to the earth. Very good, nice full breath. Take it deep, expand, and stay for the exhale. And then when you're ready, fingertips, left leg straight back, dekasana. Exhale, left knee, left elbow, crunching into the side body. Inhale, sweep the right leg up and over the right shoulder, see the toes. Stay for the exhale. Inhale, lengthen back the left leg. And exhale, left foot sets down, right foot follows. Big breath in plank. And exhale, left knee touch. Inhale, plank. Exhale, right knee touch. Inhale, plank. Exhale, low chaturanga. Inhale, up dog. And we'll lift the hip this time. Find our dog. Tuck the toes. Push the hip back and square. And settle into your downward facing dog. Take the time here. Step your feet into the comfortable distance so that the heels ground down into the earth. Wedge the hip back and square. Roll the shoulders out. Feel all four corners of the feet digging in so strong. Very good. Yeah, I was going to say, Nora, maybe shorten the distance just a little. Looks good. Doesn't need to stretch out as much, the dog. You can kind of think about how Erica does it. She like almost really triangular. Big breath here might help the heels. Yeah, palms down. Looks good. Big inhale. And stay for the exhale. Very nice. On an inhale, let's take our right leg up and open the hip with the big long line of freedom. Powerful, letting everything peel away. And gazing through the side body, nice and straight. You're so strong. Big inhale. And have your kids play water polo, they'll be strong. Inhale, kick the right leg back and square. And exhale, right knee, cross body, left elbow, touch, hold. Inhale, right knee, right elbow. Stay for the exhale. Inhale, right leg up, three dog. And exhale, right knee to nose. Let's go ahead and rise right up today. Ekapada Tadasana, balancing on the right foot. And let the right hand find the right hip. Let the left peace fingers find the left big toe. And extend out to your own degree. If you find a nice stable balance, you may extend the right hand to the side as well. Steady focus your gaze to the earth. One non-moving spot. Pick a little grain on the floor that looks like Jesus. Okay, re-bend the left leg. Take the right hand to the left foot. Take the left hand to the earth. Let the right arm thread on the inside of the right leg and find your super soldier. Beautiful transition, nice Natalie. Big inhale, pointing your pistol to the sky. And stay for the exhale, nice. Now, re-bend, release, and take the right hand on the outside of the right foot. Lay the left foot down, and see if you can take the left hand to the left hip and just pinch the right arm with the right leg. Very good, that's nice. Now, find the control. See if you can unwind it, right leg all the way back up, three dog. And shift your weight forward through plank to find chaturanga. Inhale, up dog or cobra. And exhale, back to the downward facing dog. Take a big breath in dog, push the hip back and square. And stay for the exhale. Inhale, prepare. And exhale, step forward or fly. And let the feet come down between the hands. Nice halfway lift and lengthen, beautiful. And exhale, sit the hip low, lift the heart, chair pose. Big breath, Utkatasana. If you want to gaze down, see 10 toes out in front of two knees in one line. Lift the heart back to the sky. Big breath here, sink deep. Inhale, reach high. Exhale, sink deeper. Inhale, reach higher. And exhale, take the hands down to the earth. Find Bakasana Crow. Keep the squeezing in so tight. Think of the knees tight together almost. Bring the elbows in tight. Big inhale. Heels high, hold. We'll float on the next one. Big breath in. And exhale, chatter on the back. Inhale, up dog or cobra. And exhale. Back to the downward facing dog. Settle back. Raise the hip back and square, palms down. Use the strong hands. Powerful yogis. Inhale, left leg up, open hip. Big long line of freedom. Let it all peel away. Gazing under the side body. Expand all the way across the psoas. And hold. Inhale strong, kick back, left leg square. And exhale, left knee, right elbow connection. Hold. Inhale, left knee, left elbow. Stay for the exhale. Inhale, left leg up for your dog. Exhale, left knee to nose. Set the left foot down between the hands. Rise up like a Padottanasana. Our yoga drishti focus, where we stare, gaze to one non-moving spot on the earth or a wall, but don't pick a moving spot, because that gets really challenging. And if you do shift the gaze to the side, try not to see anything until you see your thumb. You just look right at the thumb. Beautiful. And then when you're ready, re-bend. Let the left hand find the right foot. Take the right hand to the earth. Let the left arm come on the inside of the left leg. Point the right knee to the sky. Super soldier. Beautiful breaths. Powerful expansion. And when you're ready, don't fall. Release. Set the left hand to the outside of the left foot, wrapping that arm on the inside of the leg. Take the right foot down on the 90, right hand, right hip, and just pinch. Feel the power. And hold. Now see if you can come out with control. Left leg up, three dog. And exhale, shift your weight forward to plank. Give me side plank, big inhale. Exhale, toes right, heels left. And if you want to go yogi toe lock on this one, feel free or any other variations. And find the breath. And hold. When you're ready, come back from your plank. Strong heart posture. Exhale, toes left, heels right. And find your Vinyasa. Powerful. Find your expressions. And when you're ready, come back from plank to find the chaturanga. Exhale down. Inhale, up dog or cobra. And exhale, downward facing. Come back to down dog. Take a big breath. Clear it out. Big inhale, gaze forward. Bend the knees a lot. Exhale, step, float, or fly. Let the feet come down between the hands. Nice halfway lift, lengthen. And exhale, sit the hip low, lift the heart, chair. Beautiful breath. And prayer twist to the right side, left elbow hooks. Feel free to hold or fly your side crow. And any other variations of side crow. You want to float the angel. I love that variation. EPK2. Any variations? Yeah. Nice. With control, come back to the chair prayer twist. Stay for the exhale. Inhale back through chair. Exhale, twist it left. Right elbow hooked. And fly those side crows. Find your variations. If you're feeling froggy, otherwise, just feel free to hold the chair prayer. And Claw meet back in the chair, twisting. Beautiful. Nice and Ari. Inhale, chair. And exhale, fold to the earth. Bakasana crow. Bring those knees up tight. Keep the feet tight. Squeeze it all together up high. Beautiful. Three breaths. And float on the next. Inhale. Exhale, shoot back. Inhale, up dog, cobra. And exhale, downward facing. Come back to the breath. Drop to the elbows. Dolphin. Push the shoulders back and through. Feel the openness. Open the heart behind you. And when you're ready, no walls needed. Find it. Pinch up. Take your time. Settle in. And find the enjoyment. Forearms balance. Come to me.
Let yourself feel it.
How's that feel?
Spencer.
Wow. So you can, that was really good. So your head liked it.
Yeah.
Yeah. Oh, cool. Wow. Yeah, so once you started to find that on your own, I bet you could hold that. You seem so stable. I just kind of was keeping your hip in the same place. Really good. Let's try our transition from headstand to pitcher. I think that's a valuable transition to make. See if you can take the headstand, support it, and then, whoops, start to take the hands down to the earth. Start to let yourself come forward
and press it up into your pinchamayarasana. Maybe also finding hands free variations.
Beautiful.
One hand pincher.
I like it. One hand pinch is killer. Really nice.
I think that way it
looks good. So let it almost come too far. Take your hands down first. Secure the palms. And let it come too far. Look up. Yeah. See, I almost feel like for you, that helps you because the alignment is
so good.
That was really killer. Okay, let's play handstanding. And, nice. One thing that I did notice, the handstand, the little bit of hands closer together can be helpful to find a good, stable balance. So, whatever handstanding feels good, play it. Use the wall. Feel free. Take your time. So that
then just like yeah yeah
so that you're lifted.
Not talking completely, but just like.
Behind. If you'd like to reach the left arm through to spine. Sit nice and tall. Gaze out over the back shoulder. Press hard through the left foot. And breathe. Very good. On an inhale, come back through center. And exhale, counter the twisting. And then release the right leg out long. And find the opposite side. So tree pose is totally fine, totally the base of this, and very much the most important. From there, finding the half lotus, perhaps, and fold forward, or the half lotus with the bind, and folding forward. Honor the hip. Note that both sides are completely, they're independent. They may feel completely different. Take the time to plug the hip into the socket, flex the quadricep, and bow. Long spine. Rise up and bend the right knee. If you don't have the bind, feel free to leave that left foot right on the ground. And otherwise, rise up and these fingers grab right big toe, floating, and bow head to knee. And when you're ready, re-bend, take the left heel to the right sit bone. Take the right foot to the outside of the left knee. Take the right elbow, press off the left knee, twist out over the left shoulder. Maybe no bind with the arms supporting the leg, or maybe thread the right hand through. Power out of the left big toe, lift the pelvic floor, and twist. Beautiful breaths. In through the nose, out through the nose. One more big twist. There you go. Inhale, release it through center. And exhale to the opposite side. So good. And then when you're ready, release it out. Scoot forward on the mat. Find the butterfly, Baddha Konasana. Bring the hip up close to the heels and allow yourself to bow. One day hooking the toes under the chin. Breathe it out. Sit bone, bring the knees into the chest, cross up the ankles and bow the third. Come back to your intention. Come back to the breath. When you're ready, fly the legs out, peace fingers grab the big toes, Urdhva Mukha Uparishta Konasana. Steady focus the drishti to one non-moving space, or the eyes be closed. Big inhale, and exhale, round and bend. Roll yourself all the way back to plow halasana, taking the legs up and over the head, and allowing yourself to expand the back of the neck, expand the windpipe, and let the trachea sink deep into the throat. Straighten the skull, the nape of the neck. If you want to take a breath with the arms pulled together, hands in the steeple grip, pull the scapula together, and then press the hands down flat on the earth. stack the navel over the chin, and breathe. And when you're ready, bend the knees, support the low spine, push the legs straight up in the sky. Sarvangasana, queen of all the asanas. Beautiful. Big inhale. And exhale, knees to the side face. Karnapindasana. Ear pinning pose. Close off the sound of the outside world. And when you're ready, roll it down one vertebra at a time. Keeping the knees hugged into the chest, ironing the low spine flat as you go. Taking the feet down about hips width distance, grabbing a hold of the ankles, and pressing the hip up into the sky, tucking the shoulders under for bridge pose. Press the chest for the chin. Push hard through the legs. Feel free to stay here in this active bridge or take the hands up overhead and transition right up into your Urdhva Dhanurasana. And if you want to take the right leg pointing to the sky and then switch left leg up. And when you're ready, shoulders nice and open today. Exhale, take it back to the earth. Really gentle. Squeeze it in. Bring the knees into the chest. And then extend the right leg out long. Twist the left knee. Reset that. Nice back bend here. Add length. Shoulders flat down. Inhale back through the center, hugging in gently. And exhale, left leg long, right knee twisting across to the left. Gazing out over the right shoulder. Make space. Breathe it out. Twist out all the way through the neck and the chin. Inhale now, back into the center and give it the big squeeze. Wrap the shins, bring the third eye up to touch. Roll yourself up onto the low spine. And then, legs straight up the wall. Right hand tummy, left hand heart. Let the blood flow down into the root of the spine. Feel the pulse. Feel the breath. Feel the legs cooling down. Really nice. And when you're ready, take your hands to the inner thighs. Press the legs out wide in the split. And stretch out long on the mat. Shavasana. Corpse pose. Give the breath to the body. Give the body to the earth. Allow this beautiful exchange of breath to represent the exchange of life and death itself. As all fear stems from this simple fear of death, and as we let this go, there's so much freedom. Give it all away. What truly belongs to you can never be taken, and what can be taken away was never yours to begin with. Allow the purest possession of all, pure awareness, Shavasana.